this incredible property that I live in that has a terrace here and a patio there and a sitting area inside, and it, the list goes on. I do own it, and I did create it, but I don't live it. I'm here. All I do is work. Someone else can sit in those places. I am always wondering, just like retiring from skating, you're always wondering when you're not going to be able to do it anymore. When is it? What day in the calendar, what moment, what month is it that I will vacate this property? And when the day comes, I will hand over the keys and walk out the door, and I will not look back. I will look forward to the next creative challenge, and I don't feel like this is the last stop on the train. I do want to be taken seriously as an artist, but yet I really don't have to have somebody, you know, put the seal of approval on me, because my life is the real deal. I am that. I know that. And if nobody else knows it, I know it.
Welcome to the gallery.
True soul of an artist comes from within.
Taller, what are the best and worst elements of being an artist?
Well, certainly the best, the payback for any artist is the act of being creative. I have never actually ever been told what to do or how to do it. I can only imagine if one has a boss and an office or something, how horrible that would be. The worst is being poor or not having a weekly salary. And in the words of Oscar Wilde, which I have always been amused by and think is very, very accurate, but does not apply to me, he said, "I would rather earn a weekly wage than be fascinating."
Taller, can we talk about your environment, and is it a mirror image of the artist?
The environment that I live in, both indoors and outdoors, couldn't be more of a mirror image of myself. In case you hadn't noticed, I am
completely obsessive compulsive in my understanding of decoration, acquisitions, and color. Again, nobody tells me really what to do, and that's fantastic. I know that within marriages, wives and husbands have to agree on things. Fortunately for me, I make my own decisions. I have an addiction to acquiring stuff. Do not be confused by the classical understanding of what a collector is. Collectors are much more thoughtful and after specific things. What I acquire is decorative stuff that appeals to me, but each individual object is not important to me at all. What is important, Robertson Davies mentioned it in the Bread and the Bone, the sum of parts should be greater than the whole, both with the garden and also with the room.
Si me comprendieras, si me conocieras, qué feliz sería. Si me comprendieras, si me conocieras, jamás lloraría. Ya que estando lejos tú no eres ajena, porque vas conmigo. Tus siete reflejos alivian mis penas. La noche es testigo. Si me comprendieras, si me conocieras, jamás dudaría. Y mis condiciones serían las razones que tú aceptarías. Si me comprendieras, todo cambiaría, porque al fin verías que por ti estoy loco.